Hi guys, today we are going to discuss topic of dominant caste from Indian anthropology. These are the topic. I'm going to explain all this topic of dominant caste in the small gist manner. Okay, on dominant caste, this topic is given by the dominant caste by the dominant caste in Rampura by M.N. Srinivas in the year of 1959. It is a part of social change in India. According to Srinivas, if a caste should be dominant caste, there should be three factors. One factor is land. The maximum control of land should be there in the other dominant caste. Next is the numerical strength. They should be have high numerical strength. They should be have high status in the local hierarchy. These are three basic conditions for them to be a dominant caste. Now recently new factors evolved for the dominant caste. They are the Western education, jobs in the administration and political clout. If these six factors we have, we can say the caste is having dominating in that region. Okay. Dominant caste will be two levels. One will be village level, one will be the regional level. At the village level there is no importance, because there is no importance for the village level. We will give the importance of the regional level, which have good importance in the political and economic structure. Okay, what are the factors affecting dominant caste recently? One is the adult franchise. Okay, now next is a democratic decentralization by Panchayat Raj. Okay, we're getting the power from the panchayats, so and so. And SC/ST reservations in pattern, transport communications, and government schemes. All these factors are giving blow to the dominant caste. We know the concept of Sanskritization. When the lower caste going to meet the higher caste, they are imitating cultural traditions and so. This topic is Sanskritization. But then this not always rule for the Brahmins only. In some regions where dominant caste also imitated. So it is a model of the Sanskritization. Example is a dominant Thakur from landlord in UP, so and so. These are dominant caste. Examples are there. Dominant caste generally maintain the hegemony. They're watchdog of their culture. They also important for the dispute settlement in caste panchayat, in the intra caste and intra caste, so and so. S.C. Dubey and Peter Gardner, these are two established which are against the Srinivas, the concept of dominant caste. Because according to them, the importance is given to the dominance individuals, not the dominant caste. They're giving one dominant factions, not the dominant caste. Because according to them, in the total dominant caste, all the members are not the dominant. Only some of the individuals or factions will be dominant. So they are giving power for the dominant individuals and factions, not the dominant caste. This is the rival competition with S.C. Dubey as well in the Srinivas. According to Ghanshyam Shah in 1985, he had given importance of the caste association. This caste association is concept was driven by the dominant groups or dominant caste. Because to maintain hegemony, they want to maintain their hegemony accordingly. The economic strata, they should good cloud in economic strata and political strata to protect own cultural interest, own class interest. Example of this association are Kurmi Kshatriya Sabha in UP, Mahajan Sabha in Tamil Nadu and Kshatriya Sabha in Gujarat. They want to glorify their caste, glorify their past by their caste, and they bind caste members in the name of the economic issues and backward issues and so extra. One of the biggest notes is Srinivas never claimed that dominant caste totally control the power of rural India. They generally dominate but not the total domination of the rural India. Dominant caste generally manipulate all the welfare schemes and democratic institutions and so extra. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel.